Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1742, Risk Factor, Three-Way Lookup as Conditional Format. Hey, we got a doozy sent in this morning by Tom. Tom has a table. They enter an age and a gender and a ratio. And based on that, so we figure out the age, figure out the gender, and then where they fall in this list, there is a risk factor, low, moderate, high, or very high. And he wants to conditionally format this cell. This is tough. This is, you know, you have to look up, it's a three-way lookup because you have to look up the age, you have to look up the gender, and then figure out where we fall in these ranges. But this table isn't set up very friendly for doing a three-way lookup. So I'm going to go on to the next sheet here where I have rewritten Tom's table, and I put all of the male on the left-hand side, all of the female on the right-hand side, and then I changed his friendly words here, 20 to 29 years, to the lower limit, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, to match the groups. And I had to change the risk factors, so less than 0.83, I put a 0, and then 0.83 to 0.88, I just put the lower limit here, and then greater than 0.94, I put a new lower limit of 0.95. So I had to recreate Tom's table here in order to do this. Now it kind of becomes somewhat simple that we're just doing, really, when you get right down to it, a one-way lookup. We're looking at this 0.97 in four cells. The trick is it's going to be a different four cells every time. And so I'm going to use a function called offset to figure out where those four cells go. Now the offset always specifies a starting location, and for me I'm using C15. Why C15? Because I know that I'm going to want to go over some number, but I don't want to have to go down any rows. So this is kind of the starting row. So I'll start from C15, and then I have to figure out how far to go over. And to figure out how far to go over, it's going to be a bit of a calculation. I'm going to use the match function, go look for M or F in this range. If it's M, it's going to give me a position of 1. If it's F, it's going to give me a position of 6. So I'm either going to get 1 or 6 there. Let's test that out. I actually haven't tested it before the podcast. There we go. So F gives us a position of 6. And then figure out how far to go over for age. Well, now, while this match was an exact match, the 0, we had to find exactly M or F. This match is equivalent to a VLOOKUP with true, where we want to find the value just less than. So we look up the age in this range, and I didn't bother to change the range over here because it's identical age ranges, luckily for me. So look for C2 and C14 to G14. When you don't find it, give me the value that is just less than. So this person here at 38 is the second column. If they were 58, then they would be over in the fourth column. All right, so we start from C15. We go over 6 cells to get to the female, go over 4 cells to get to the right age, but then we're 1 too many. We're 1 too many, so actually from here we go 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have to subtract 1 from that whole thing. All right, so here we go. Ready? So we start from equal match of this ratio. Press F4, comma. The lookup array is going to be the offset of this starting cell. I'll press F4. How many rows down? No rows down. How many columns over? Okay. Well, that's where we have all of these different pieces that we have to put together. We're going to do the match of the gender, F4, comma, in this range. F4, and we want an exact match there, so we'll use the 0, plus the match of the age, F4, comma, in this range, F4, at this time we want a less than match, the true version of VLOOKUP, and then minus 1, because we're always going over 1 too many columns, so that's how many columns over. And then how tall is the table? The table is 4 rows tall, 1 column wide. All right, so that finishes our offset. And then in that match, we are doing a less than match, the true version of VLOOKUP, which is equivalent to a 1. And that whole big thing there should get us the correct position in the risk here, low, moderate, high, or very high. Low, moderate, high, or very high. All right, so let's just do a test. We will change back to male, back to 38, and 0.88. And they are a risk factor of 2. So male, 38, 0.88 falls into 2. Let's try 0.78. Should be a risk factor of 1. All right, so we've now got this formula returning the 1, 2, 3, or 4 for us. And I was surprised Tom had actually gone through, and he had tried this before, apparently, because he was using a helper cell of B21, and I was using a helper cell of C20. So let's just keep Tom's conditional formatting there. For right now, I will copy this. I need everything to point to the exact same spot. And did I use dollar signs throughout? Yes. Yes, I did. All right, so Control C, Control V. All right, so there, now the green is working. And we can try some other things here. So 1.03, very high. All right, looks like it's working well. Now, what if we didn't want this helper cell down here? Well, what we could do is go into this formula. We will copy the formula to the clipboard, including the equal sign, Control C. Come back here, Alt OD, and we're going to edit each of Tom's rules, and where he has equal B21, I'll delete that and paste in the formula. Click OK, and repeat, 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 repeat for the others, and then we can get rid of the helper cell. It's all working right there in that single cell. Now we still have to keep my version of the table instead of Tom's version of the table. Looks like Tom did some nice border formatting there, and I'll leave that up to Tom to go through. Although the one thought that I had, and something that Tom did not ask for, but I thought would be fun to do, what if we took this match formula, or this match formula, I have two different ones, I decided to show the first one in the podcast, and started from a specific cell, so perhaps cell M14, and said that we wanted to go from there down 1, 2, 3, or 4 cells, so it actually returns the word down here. Now you're saying, hey, that's no good. He wanted color formatting. Well, watch this trick. So I took this formula, the big offset formula, and I assigned it to a name. So I went to formulas, define name, and we'll actually take a look at it here in the name manager. I called it rating, and it is that big formula. I was careful to point to the sheet in every case. So instead of just M14, I was using final M14, and so on. I fully qualified that. So we're going to take this cell, Control C. I'm going to go up here and put it next to my rating, and I'm going to home, paste as linked picture, which gets me a picture of this cell. All right, now watch this amazing trick. Instead of always pointing to M14, the picture is pointing to M14. I'm going to backspace through that and type my named formula, equal rating, and press enter. And now I'm getting not just the word, but a picture of the word. So here we'll change this person to be 68 and bump them up to 1.13. And the conditional formatting works, but I'm also getting the word with the right color directly from these cells. A cool, cool trick there. All right, so hey, I want to thank Tom for sending this question in. I hope that Tom doesn't mind that I rearranged this table down here, but you know, that's really what we need to do in order to make these lookups work correctly. And I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.